गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ यू ऑल? होप यू ऑल फाइन एंड सेफ। आई बिलीव दैट यू ऑल अंडरस्टूड व्हाट आई थॉट इन द लास्ट वीडियो क्लास। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द लेसन वेयर आई स्टॉप्ड। नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट कॉइन्स। ओके, लुक एट द कॉइन चिल्ड्रन। आई थिंक यू ऑल नो दिस इज अवर 5 रुपीज कॉइन, इज़न्ट इट? Can you tell what and all information get from this coin? In this coin, you are having our lion emblem, that is our Indian government emblem, and below that Indian government motto, Satyameva Jayate, and the name of the country India, written Hindi as well as English. That means these two languages are the official languages of India, isn't it? And backside of the coin, we are having the value of the coin and also in the year which this coin was introduced. So this many information we are getting from this coin. Imagine a person going to see this coin after 100 years. This information from these coins, like that the coins released by the ruler before 100 and 1000 years ago, so many information about their kingdom, isn't it? That only we are going to learn now. Okay, the study of coins is known as numismatic. The study of coins means we should know what and all information they are inscribed on that coins. For that study about that coin, that study is known as numismatic. Not only study, some people are having habit of collecting the coins, that also known as numismatics. Okay, first point, listen carefully children. Now I am going to read the lesson. The picture on the coins convey the names of kings, which their title and portraits, events, place, dates, dynasties and logos. So with the king introduced, one coin means in that coin the king inscribed his name with this title and portraits and events. Some events also inscribe that coin, place where that coin released and date when the coin was released and dynasties and logos. The inscribe that logo also in their coins. So if you get one coin from that coin, we can understand that name and the title of the king who released and his image, and when and where he released that coin and the name of the dynasty and about that logos. These things we can get from these coins. The composition of metal in the coins gives us information on the economic condition of the emperor. So composition of metals means if want to make one coin means we have to made it using some metals, isn't it? Which metal there are used to make that coin twice the economic condition of empire. For example, I am saying gold means it's having more value, and silver means it is value lesser than gold. And if you taken copper means it is value very much lesser than silver. So this all are different types of metals used to make coins. From the value of these metals, we can get the information of economic condition of the empire. Mention of kings, achievement like military conquest, territorial expansion, trade links and religious faith also found in the coins. So kings, achievements, what the achievements of kings? Getting victory by the military movement and territorial expansion to spread his kingdom. Trade links means business dealing and religious faith also found in the coins. Mohammad Ghori, who is the inventor of Turkey, has stamped the figure of goddess Lakshmi on his gold coin and had his name inscribed on it. From that we can understand that the Turkish inventor was liberal in his religious outlook. What name I mentioned here first? Mohammad Ghori. Who is inventor of the Turkey? What he did means stamped the figure of goddess Lakshmi on his gold coins and also had his name inscribed on it. Actually, he is Islamic invader. From that we can understand that the Turkish inventor was liberal in his religious outlook. That means he gives equal importance to all religions. Okay. Copper jitals and silver tanga, which were introduced by Iltutmish, gave more information about Delhi sultans. A jital contained 3.6 grains of silver. 48 jitals were equal to 1 silver tanga. Look at this picture, children. So many letters in this coin. For example, if you having 1 rupee coin means actually it is a 100 paise is equal to 1 rupee. 48 jital were equal to 1 silver tanga. Alauddin Khilji's gold coin, Muhammad bin Tughlaq's copper token currency or indicative of coinage as well as economic prosperity of the country. Dear children, I hope you all understood very well about the lesson. Children, learn and write true or false answer in one or two sentences. Thank you children. Have a nice day.